Today I'm going to show you how to create a convincing tilt shift effect. Hello my friends, and let's get started. So to create a convincing tilt shift effect, you have to do more than just apply the blur filter, because you have to understand how and why it works. So the first thing we need to do is to look at the viewing angle. Here we have a guy, which is, by the way, not me, and he's sitting at a piano looking down at it. So you can see that there's a certain angle that he's looking down, and we can see from the degrees that is somewhere around 40 to 45 degrees. And of course, it can be a little bit lower, like 30 degrees, or a bit higher, up to 50 or 55 degrees. So somewhere in that area is our natural way of looking downwards onto a plane like it's sitting in front of us on the table. And this is most convincing to us when we want to trick our brain into seeing the world like a toy world. So when we look at this picture, you can see that it is laid out before us like a table, like a plane that could be a toy world. On the other hand, if you look at this picture, at the first moment, it does look pretty convincing with the blur around it, but the brain is not really convinced that this is real, because if we turn off the blur, you can see that all of this is happening on the same plane. So the degree of the plane is much too close for the edges of it to be that unsharp. It shouldn't look like that. So this is only convincing in the first moment when you see, well, it's pretty fake. While here, it's kind of hard. You don't really know. Maybe it's plastic figurines. Maybe it's a real photo. You can't really tell. So when you, of course, when you look at the complete picture, you can tell. And here we have another picture with a town where also the angle is pretty okay. And it looks like this city is set out in front of us on a table. So let's go back to this picture, delete the effect, and apply it from scratch. So you want to select the picture plane or the picture layer and go down here to live filters, because you want to change around, experiment with it a little bit and not apply the effect in one go. So we select depth of field filter. There we go. And the first thing it does is to suggest us a round or elliptical filter, which is not the right one for this effect. We have to use down here, it says mode, go over to tilt shift. It's even named after that. It's pretty good. And this will give us a straight line blur. If you want to know why it is a straight line blur, we have to go a little bit into history. So the reason for it is that it started all with these cameras. It is not like with the modern cameras like this one, where there is a hard tube connecting the camera to the lens. In the beginning, you have these kind of folding lenses, and of course, they could tilt in all kinds of directions. And if you tilt them, you would get a straight line of sharpness in the middle, and then you would get blur in straight areas up and below the part where you tilted the camera. So this is where basically this kind of photography comes from. Of course, in more modern cameras, you have lenses that actually tilt to the side or shift. That's why it's called tilt or shift. You can do both with these lenses. And by the way, tilt shift is just a name that we use for something. It's actually called miniature faking, because tilt and shift is actually used for something completely different. It's mostly used in architecture photography to correct perspective and get something without distortion. So as you can see here, if you just change the angle of your camera without changing the angle of your lens, you would get this kind of, manipulation? No, what's the right word? Perspective distortion, I'm sorry. And if you shift the lens upwards, you can photograph the subject without perspective distortion. So this is mainly the use. And this is the way it's used here, is like more of a digital effect to be applied and to be fun and look like a toy world. Okay, let's go back to our picture after this little history lesson, and we look at the tool that we have. So you have these blue points here. The one in the middle without a line is to move around the whole effect over your picture where you want it to be. The other ones are, this one that is closer to the middle is where the blur should basically start, or yeah, whether it's closest, the blur is closest to the sharp part in the middle, and the outer ones are where you basically reach the maximum blur value for the picture. And if you want to move them without changing the angle of the lines, hold your shift button on the keyboard and then you can move them up and down without disturbing the angle. But what you can do, for example, in this picture, because you can see that the angle is a little bit off to the side, you can of course rotate the effect a little bit to apply an effect like it would happen to your eye that is simulating a little bit the degree the plane is laying out in front of you. So let's apply some blur, which is done with the radius down here. And what you can see is, first of all, it's getting blurry, but also we get these white edges around our picture. We don't want to have that. And the reason why this happens is because the picture is getting blurred, but there's no more picture information outside. So it's replacing it with transparency, which is getting white. So what we have to do is click here on Preserve Alpha, and this will restore the edges so they are still filled with pixels. So the next thing we can do is, of course, play around with the sharpness that we want to have, or the blur, the value of blur with the radius. And then you have two more, which is vibrance. Vibrance is giving more color to the picture, but mostly in the blurred areas. And clarity is a detail contrast, basically, which is based not just on the values of the darkness and brightness, but also on the details that you have in the picture. You can apply it if you want. So this is really up to your taste, what you want to do with the picture, how it should look. And again, with these blue points here, you can adjust where the blur is starting and ending and how far it's fading over the picture. So let's see. If we move this in, and this in, you can see that it's now getting blurred in a very short distance, which is not ideal for us, so we will change that back. Hold the shift key so you don't change the rotation of your effect. Move this in a little bit, maybe here. And then on the other side, we can also decide maybe move this in a little bit more and this in a little bit more. So we can play around with this until you get the desired effect. You know, you have this feeling that it looks like a toy world. Let's see. Maybe go like this. Close it. And this looks pretty good, actually. And again, if you go in and you take the middle part, the middle point here, you can, of course, move it around in the picture and select another part. So maybe we want the kids in the background to be a little bit in the blur. There we go. And when you close, it's hiding the line so you can see the effect that was created. So this is basically how you create a tilt shift effect, how you set the different parameters. And in this case, we also adjusted it a little bit to the background. And with playing around with it a little bit, you get something that's really convincing to the eye and makes sense in a sense that it looks like a toy world. Okay, this was the episode for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you want to see more of my videos, consider subscribing. I do a new video every 3 days. And if you want to support me, head over to Patreon, where you get a lot more benefits, like my original files with all the layers. You can live chat with me. I give you feedback for your pictures, and you can even suggest topics for the upcoming videos. Thank you very much, and see you soon. Bye.